It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS AM 1160, 101.1 FM. Our conversation with Rachel Bertsche is brought to you by Marcus & Mack, a law firm representing injured people. And the name of the book is The Kids Are in Bed. Rachel joins us this morning. Finding time for yourself in the chaos of parenting. Rachel, good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Oh, it's great to have you on the air with us here today on Indiana in the Morning. And I love the book. I love the term that you come up with, and I don't know if it's yours or somebody else's, but it really fits. Pockets of indulgence, not buckets of indulgence, not boatloads, just pockets of indulgence. Tell me how that term evolved.
Yeah, no, that was something that I was thinking about a lot because we were talking about me time and this idea of having time for yourself, but it felt so amorphous to people, and it felt like they never had any of it. And so I started thinking about how you really need to kind of carve out this little moment that has a beginning and an end. And as you say, it's not buckets. No parents have buckets of free time. But if you can carve out even small pockets of time, you can really get a lot of kind of restorative energy from that.
Yeah, one of the things that I always tell folks is that it's not that you don't have the time, it's that you choose to use it in other ways. That's not necessarily the case with parents, though. Do parents actually not have time, or are they just not managing time? What is the issue here?
I think what you said is exactly right. People do have some time, not a ton of time, but when they have it, they're either thinking about all of the things that they should be doing or wish they were doing or feel guilty that they're not doing, so that time doesn't feel good and doesn't feel kind of energizing, or they're so wiped out from parenting and working and thinking about all those things that they don't use it in a way that feels good. I hear from so many parents that say, you know, my kids go to bed, I'm wiped out, I just sort of stare at the wall or stare at my phone, and then suddenly an hour has passed and time for bed, and I feel like I wasted my night. So I think there's this idea that we're just kind of, there's so much decision fatigue that suddenly we're paralyzed when we do have the time.
So how does Rachel Bertsche one day say to herself, I got to write this. This is a book waiting to be written, and I'm the person to write it.
Well, it's funny, I'm just like all the people that I hope are reading my book. I have two young kids, I work full time. I was really time strapped, and I was talking to a friend who finally said to me, but when do you watch TV? And what she meant really was that she knows that I kind of love nothing more than to settle into the couch and with a blanket and a good show. And really, I think what she was saying was, when do you take care of yourself? And so I started thinking about that because it was something I heard from so many other parents as well who would say, you know, I used to read books, but I don't have time now. And I would say, what do you do when your kids are in bed? Because then there is that chunk of time, and it was, well, I have to clean up, or I have to finally catch up on all the things I didn't do. So I really wanted to look at this idea of, like, is that true? Do we really not have time, and how can we fix this?
Well, you spend the first part of the book exploring that, the idea of the time issue itself, and then you get into you personalize it, and you do a part two of the book, three different sections. One's on marriage, one's on self-care, one's on friendship. So our most intimate relationship, our own selves, and then the people around us who might not be right there with us all the time, but they're vital parts of our families, and the fact that our friendships are so important to us. Tell me about coming up with that sort of a structure. Why were those the areas that you chose to approach it from?
Yeah, I think that those are the areas in our life that sort of take the biggest hit when we have kids. Those are areas that we make time for and have time for before we have children often. And then suddenly those are the first to go. Friendships, for sure. I think I hear from people all the time, you know, that as soon as they had children, they just didn't have time to see their friends or connect with their friends. Self-care, like exercise or even just going to the doctor or having time alone. You know, I always say that I used to, like, listen to music in the shower, but now I just, like, need quiet because it's so loud in my house all the time with two young kids. And connecting with a spouse or a romantic partner, because the first time I went out to dinner with my husband after we had our daughter, we spent the whole dinner looking at pictures of our daughter. You know, so we kind of forget to connect on that other level, and I think it's important to remember that you are more than a parent. You were someone before you had these kids, and it's important to remember and connect with that person.
Rachel Bertsche is our guest. The book is The Kids Are in Bed, Finding Time for Yourself in the Chaos of parenting. Talk a little bit more about that that intimate relationship with your most romantic partner and why that's important to be sure that that is maintained.
Absolutely. I mean, the research unfortunately shows that once you have kids, your marital, most the marital happiness sort of declines pretty precipitously. Kids are, the chapter is called The Baby Bomb because it is sort of like a bomb exploded in your relationship when you're, especially in those early days when you have an infant who isn't sleeping and everyone's sleep deprived and kind of on edge. But that's a relationship that, you know, you want to maintain, and it's, I think sometimes it doesn't have to be getting a babysitter and going for date nights, and I think that's something, the child care piece is something that really kind of prevents people from doing that. But once your kids are asleep, hopefully you have some time to just you talk to that person and talk about things other than scheduling logistics and other than sort of look at this cute picture of our baby.
Yeah, it can't just be a remember when type of relationship, can it?
Exactly. Yeah. And you know, more people, they're just introduced in the household, introduces more, kind of more opportunities for complication, but it's important to kind of just connect the two of you.
You know, one of the interesting things about the author interviews that we're able to do frequently, they'll cite this survey or that survey that helps to back up whatever their point is. You actually conducted a survey in order to put this book together. Did it show you what you thought you were going to find out?
It did, yes. I conducted a survey of 500 parents, a nationally representative survey of 500 parents across the country, and it did. You know, one of the most striking things we learned from that survey was this idea that more than 70% of the parents said that their free time didn't feel free because they were still thinking about all the things they should or could be doing. But we also kind of took away some really great pieces of advice. For example, we found a group of parents we call the role models, and these are the parents who do feel good about the time that they have to themselves. And those people prioritize time with friends, and they prioritize exercise over, you know, chores and time spent on the internet. So that was really helpful to say, okay, here's some things we can learn and some things that maybe we could do that'll make us feel better overall.
Yeah, and we don't have to be jealous of them, and we don't have to be angry with them because they've been able to figure out some things that we're still working on either, do we?
Yes, absolutely. I think we should all sort of take that as inspiration. And I don't. It doesn't. You don't have to run a marathon. You know, it doesn't have to be this big, long chunk of time or this big investment. Just 20 minutes a day really does make a difference. You know, talking on the phone with a friend, or just connecting over lunch, or getting in a 20-minute workout, you know, in your living room after your kids are asleep. So I think there are small hacks to make it work, even if you're very busy. And I think people get sort of defensive when you say, oh, take time for yourself, because they feel like I don't have that time. But it doesn't have to be a big time investment.
Just a moment or two left with Rachel Bertsche, the author of the book, The Kids Are in Bed, Finding Time for Yourself in the Chaos of Parenting. So what have you heard about the book since it's been out and since people have had a chance to read it? I know you're big on feedback. You have to be in order to learn if what you wrote hit home.
Yeah, I've heard from a lot of parents, both, you know, friends and readers that, you know, have just picked up the book and have all said, oh my gosh, this really speaks to me, this idea of sort of losing myself in parenting. And people saying, I feel inspired. I just got an email last night from someone that said, because of you, I just put the kids to bed, and instead of starting work and housework, I'm going to watch a show for myself, and then I'm going to start doing these things. So hopefully people will just feel okay and feel like they've been given permission to take time for themselves.
There you go. Given permission. I like that. The Kids Are in Bed, Finding Time for Yourself in the Chaos of Parenting. Rachel Bertsche, thank you so much for spending some time with us this morning.
Thank you so much.